Hello learners, I welcome all of the students at NIOS Studio. Myself Dr. Alok Kumar Upadhyay, reader in special education, All India Institute of Speech and Hearing, Mysore. Today I will discuss with all of you about the adaptive skills for various children with special need and the role of the teacher. So today, so we should move to topic. So first, the objectives means what we will cover in this topic. So first thing we will cover, that is characteristics of children with special needs. Second, understanding the importance of adaptive skills, development of various areas such as conceptual, social and practical skills. And in the last, we will discuss about the role of teacher for children with special need to enhancing all these adaptive skills. So let us one by one we will discuss. So first we will discuss about children who display the following disabilities or disorders generally need more support and assistance. Those children are known as attention disorders, autism, or ASD means autistic spectrum disorder, behavioral disorders, brain disorders and injuries, developmental delays, learning disabilities, social and emotional disorders, sensory and motor impairment, or other than these. Why we should know about the characteristics of children with special need? Because if we do not know about the characteristics of different type of children with special need, we cannot proceed about the adaptive skill and how they will learn the adaptive skill. So for that purpose, the children who have attention deficit or disorder, they need some attention, and by that attention we can improve the adaptive skills, like that for autistic children, for behavioral disorder or other children. So these are the characteristics of children with special need. Now we should think about the adaptive skill. What is the adaptive skill? To which we say this is adaptive skills. So we can say the adaptive skills refer to ways an individual meets his or her personal needs as well as deals with natural and social demands and expectations in their environment consistent with their age, social, class and culture. Or we can say abilities or skills, or abilities and skills that enable a person to function effectively and independently daily at home, school, work and the community. So adaptive skills we can say by which a person can function effectively and independently in day-to-day life at home, school, work or the community. But these adaptive skills are not a one or two, but these skills has a comprehensive range of skills. So for our purpose, we can divide these adaptive skills in three sub skills. The first one is conceptual skill, and in conceptual skills domains communication, functional academics and self direction. And the second one is social skill. The domain includes social skills and leisure. The third one we can divide as practical skill. Under practical skill, domains are coming as self-care, home and school living, community use, health and safety, and work. Now you can understand about the range of adaptive skills. So one by one we will discuss or we will explain about these skills. The first one is communication. Under communication, three things are very important: speech, language, listening skills needed for communication with other people, including vocabulary, responding to questions, conversation skills, etc. For day-to-day life, as we all know, that communication is very important. If we don't have a communication skill, or if we don't have a good communication skills, we cannot survive in the society. We can feel difficulty how to survive in society. So, this is the first and foremost adaptive skill. It is known as communication skill. Under this, we should know about the how to speech, language and listening skills. The second is functional academics. This is also an adaptive skill. Under this, basic reading, writing, mathematics and other academic skills needed for daily independent functioning, including telling time, measurement, writing notes and letters, etc. This is also a very important adaptive skills. Without having this adaptive skill, it is also very difficult to survive in society. If we cannot read functionally, if we cannot write functionally, if we do not know about the numbers or compute the numbers, so we cannot survive properly in the day-to-day life or in the society. So, this is also an important adaptive skill. Third one is coming as a self-direction. Self-direction is skills needed for independence, responsibility, self-control, including starting and completing task, keeping a schedule, following time limits, following direction, making choices, etc. All these things comes under self-direction. If we are not able or we don't have such type of a skill, then again we will face difficulty. So, this is also a very important sub skills under the adaptive skill. The next one is social. In social, this social skill needed to interact socially and get along with other people, including having friends, showing and recognizing emotions, assisting others and using manners. As we all know, to live in society, the interaction is very important. Interaction with known people or the unknown people, or to make a friends, or recognizing the emotion. So, this is also a very important adaptive skill. If we are not learned with this skill, then we will face so much difficulties. Leisure is also a important sub adaptive skills. This skill needed for engaging in the planning, leisure, recreational activities, including playing with others, engaging in recreation at home, following rules in the games, etc. So, leisure is also a very important sub skill under adaptive skill. In leisure means when we are going to play or we are playing a game, so what rules are there in the play, we should always follow those rules, we should always keep disciplined for the rules. All these things come under the leisure skills. How to live at the home, how to engage our time at home with the leisure, all these things comes under the leisure sub skill. The next one is self-care. Self-care is also very important sub skill under the adaptive skill. A skill needed for personal care, including eating, dressing, bathing, toileting, grooming, hygiene, etc. As we know, all these things are also known as a basic life skills. If we do not have ability for toileting, for grooming, for hygiene, for eating, for dressing or for bathing, we cannot proceed our life. So, these are very important, or we can say these are the basic life skill. It comes as, or it is known as a self-care skills. It comes under the adaptive skill. Next is home living. A skill needed for basic care of a home or living setting, including cleaning, straightening, property maintenance and repairs, food preparation, performing chores, etc. So, these things comes under the home living skill. So, how to live at home, what things we should do for home, how we cleanize our home, how to maintain our home or our property, all those things related to the home living skill. Community use. This is also an adaptive skill. Skill needed for functioning in the community, including use of community resources, shopping skills, getting around in the community, etc. So, as we all are the part of community, so in community we have so many facilities or so many things, how to use those things, how to engage ourselves for using those things, it is also very important, and it comes as a adaptive skills. If we do not know how to go to the shop, how to get some things, or how to go in a park, what we will do in the parks, how we meet with other peoples in the community. So, all these things are important. So, we can say this is also a very important adaptive skill for a person who is surviving in the society. Next is health and safety. Skills needed for protection of health and to respond to illness and injuries, including following safety rules, using medicines, showing cautions, etc. Health and safety is also a sub skill under adaptive skills. A child, if do not know what things is hazardous for life, what things are harmful for life, or what are good for life, then it will be difficult to survive. So, all those things, what is good for or what is bad for us, if we do not know, it will be difficulty for us, which medicine is good for health, which medicine is not good for health, or what equipments we will touch that is not problematic or hazardous to us, and what type of equipments we will touch, then it will be harmful for us. These things are very important. All these things comes under a sub skill that is known as health and safety skill. Next is work. Work is also a skill. Skills needed for successful functioning and holding a part time or a full time job in a work setting, including completing work tasks, working with supervisor, and following a work schedule. Under this sub skills, we learn or we adapt to know about how to work in a part time, how to do job in a part time or a full time, what are the time setting in that workplace, what is the work task, and how we should work with the supervisor or the juniors, what type of behavior we should keep with us for doing work in the working schedule. So, this is also an important skill. So, all these known as a adaptive skills, these are very important for successful life or leading a successful life. Now, question comes for children with special needs, because they have a special need. So, maybe because of any disability or because of disability, they have some difficulty to learn these skills, and these skills are very important to lead a successful life. So, how we can give the skills or impart the skill to the student? This is the burning question. Here the role of teacher come in picture, because teacher is the person who know better than any other the child requirement, child needs, or what type of strategies the teacher will use to impart that skill or these skills. So, for that purpose, the role of teacher is very crucial, very important. Here we can think that teacher must be a good planner, because if teacher will not be a good planner, he cannot impart any type of skill. Whatever skill I discuss with you, all those skills are very important for successful life. So, one by one, or maybe all the skills or maybe some skills are not there in the children. So, it is the duty of the teacher or responsibility of the teacher or the role of the teacher, that teacher will make a good plan how to impart those skills. For that purpose, the teacher will plan ki these activities we will do for imparting that particular skill. So, it should be very carried out very systematically. The second thing is, it should be the duty of teacher to give more and more opportunity to the child. More and more opportunity for what purpose? More and more opportunity for the imparting the particular skill. So, skill related activities, whatever the teacher planned, those activities going through many times, because to impart or to skill a child, the child with special need is very much difficult. So, for that purpose, it is the responsibility of the teacher that he will give more, he or she will give more and more opportunity to impart that particular skill. Third one is, teacher should act as an innovator by introducing some innovative program to inculcate the skill. It is the duty of the teacher that teacher should work as an innovator. Innovator means it is not that it will be very scientific, but the teacher should keep in mind the difficulty of child, and teacher also should have in the mind that what new activities and interesting activities should do with the child, that child will learn, child will get the knowledge or skill related to that adaptive skill. For that purpose, teacher may plan playway activities as a innovative activities, teacher may plan any other type of activities as a innovator. So, these activities will be helpful for all the children. And the next one is, the teacher, he or she should to act like a director, recorder, or we can say evaluator, manager, decision maker, advisor, motivator, communicator, coordinator, etc. As we all know, teacher is not only a teacher. Teacher sometimes may be director, sometime may be recorder, sometime may be evaluator, sometime may be manager, or different type of roles are there for the teacher, because teacher know very well about the child than any other people. So, what role will be a good for the child at that time? So, teacher will do like that. So, by this way, teacher role is very crucial, and teacher can do everything for the child, and teacher can inculcate any skill, whatever skills be discussed in adaptive skills. So, those skills can be imparted easily through the teacher to the child. So, today we discussed about the adaptive skills and role of the teacher. Now, we are going for break, and after that we will discuss another topic. Thank you very much.